Hare Krishna. We don't have to be fearless to be brave. We often think that that those who are brave, those who are courageous, that they are free from fear. And when we need to do something which is challenging, something which is very difficult to do, which involves risk and danger and threat, and when we start getting nerves, we start feeling fear, then we think, maybe I am not qualified to do something like this. However, those who are brave are not necessarily fearless. Because first of all, being fearless is not always a virtue. Fear is a healthy and sometimes necessary reaction to the presence of danger. But if fear becomes our driving and defining emotion, and that decides, based on that emotion alone, we decide what we will do and what we will not do, then we are being controlled by our fears. But if you understand that, okay, this fear is an indicator of the presence of danger, and sometimes that danger is real, sometimes that danger might even be imaginary. That means we are only thinking that there is a great danger, but there is no really great danger. So, whichever way it is, if we understand that fear is just an emotion and we don't need to be free from fear to be brave, what we need is to have a purpose and a commitment to a purpose that helps us go beyond fear. That means, if we focus on something which is truly important for us, then even in the presence of fear, we will do something. Say we may be afraid of driving at night, but if a loved one is very sick and has been hospitalized, we may decide, despite the darkness and despite the fear that we have, we will still drive to the hospital. So similarly for us, how do we get that purpose that is bigger than fear? So, to be brave, we don't need to be free from fear. To be brave, we need to have a purpose bigger than fear. So, to cultivate that purpose bigger than fear, what we fundamentally need is the understanding that every one of us has to, that we are parts of God, that we are on a journey of eternal spiritual evolution. And in this journey, if we just keep taking steps forward gradually, one by one by one, then eventually we will rise above fear. Abhayam sattva samshuddhir jnana yoga vyavasthiti danam damascha yagyascha svadhyayastapa arjavam. So the Bhagavad-Gita says, abhayam sattva samshuddhir, that abhaya, fearlessness, is a characteristic of the godly nature. So when we understand that we are parts of God and that we are meant to serve God and that we are on an eternal journey of spiritual evolution towards Him, then that understanding our own indestructibility, understanding that our purpose cannot be thwarted, even if specific things that we do along that, while pursuing that purpose, may not work out, then we can, by learning to redefine all of our activities as service to God, get a purpose beyond, purpose that is bigger than fear, and thus get the courage, get bravery even in the presence of fear. Hare Krishna.